Let's say it again. Namma Bengaluru. Okay, I want to say welcome to Mind Rocks. I hope over the next few hours your mind truly rocks and you're able to enjoy this day. Please first welcome one of India's number one best-selling authors. He's sold more than 12 million copies. His books have become major blockbuster movies. Please welcome the one and only Chetan Bhagat.
Hi, guys.
Chetan, welcome to Mind Rocks. We're going to discuss with you about how your books have actually become really symbols of social change in this country. And what is the Chetan Bhagat formula? You see, like Manmohan Desai had a formula, the film director. With films like Amar Akbar Anthony, he would do blockbuster movies. What is the Chetan Bhagat formula for writing a blockbuster bestseller?
Okay, I'll have to kill you, but I will tell you. No, actually I've been around a long time now, Rajdeep. It's been 20 years since my first book came out. And I've also tried to answer this question. What is it that works? Because I wish I knew. I've tried ChatGPT and all. It doesn't tell me. But the best explanation I've seen so far from all the things is that it comes from this guy, Rick Rubin, who's a music producer, who's a big music producer. He says, whenever you create something, create it for yourself, even if nobody was reading it. Nobody was watching it. If you're creating a video, it's relevant to, if you're making music, nobody will listen to that song. Create it for yourself, and it should come from within you, some sort of a self-expression. And that is what is likely to work. The more you think that this is going to work in the market, or this is going to be liked by readers, or if you're making a TV program, that this program will become viral, it almost never does. The only time something truly works, and I've seen it in my books also, I mean, all the books have not done the same. So the books that have worked the best are those that I did for myself. And it's becoming harder and harder, because I've been around 20 years. You do get affected by positive feedback, by negative feedback. The moment you start caring about how well the book is doing, how badly it's doing, how well do people are praising you, how much they're criticizing you, that's when the formula breaks down. The formula is to, it has to come from within you, and keeping that for 20 years is hard. But I think for any piece of art, that is the secret.
Let me turn to 20 years ago. I want to ask this audience, how many of you have seen a movie called Three Idiots?
Of course, you don't get Aadhaar card if you don't see the movie. If you are an Indian citizen, you have to see it. And it's a requirement to get Aadhaar card.
Okay, let me ask this audience who've seen the movie, how many of you know on which book the movie is based?
Yeah, 5 point someone, 2 States, those are other movies. 2 States is another movie, yes.
Okay, so 5 point someone was the movie, was your book, your first book, which eventually became the basis for Three Idiots. Was it, again, much more a reflection of someone who had come from IIT, who had gone to IIT, then found something very different with his life? Was it partly autobiographical? Was it also one of the successes of a book is when you are able to write on your personal experience? And was 5 point someone, in a way, what Aamir Khan portrayed in Three Idiots, was that somewhere Chetan Bhagat seeing himself on screen?
Yes, but I didn't do Zubi Dubi in campus. But yes, it was the story of my friends. I mean, actually, I would say that was my purest book, because nobody knew me. I was not popular. I was not playing to the gallery. I was not trying to create the bestseller. I was literally writing my college story. I never thought it'll get so much traction and do so well. And in fact, Rajdeep, I've written more than 10 books, but the two that have done the best are that have come from my life. 5.7 and 2 states. If you ask people what are Chetan's books, the most popular ones are these two. And these two are based on my life. And I think because of that, they are more true representation of me. And that definitely works.
So 5.7 was in a sense a reflection on the state of our education system.
Yes.
So do you believe that the more you write about issues that, you know, we are in a college campus, the more you write about issues that concern people, people are also able to identify then with your theme. It's not just Chetan Bhagat writing about his life experiences, but many people, thousands, millions may well share those experiences. Is that also important?
Yes. If you notice any of the writers or movies that have become classics, they represented something that was happening in society in a very creative way. In a creative way, they are a mirror, like a Charles Dickens stories at that time. And I would like to think some of my books. And that's why, Rajiv, I want to bring a point which is not linked to my books. But we see sometimes people get so upset about one movie that how could they show this? You know, how could this creator show this? Or a web series, how could like this IC814 show this? How could they show that? And they could show that because it is some artist, some creator making it. And they will introduce their bias in it. It is impossible not to. But this is where art is created. True art is going to offend some people. True art is going to upset some people. When I wrote that book on IIT, it talked about IIT professors being very draconian and things like that. So obviously they were upset about it, right? But now if we start like mob attacking the creators, saying, how dare you make this? How dare you make that? You're basically cutting self-expression of the artists in your society, and ultimately you're going to cut your self-expression. You're basically saying, we want to live in a society where somebody is in charge and we are the slaves. How dare you walk out of line? How dare you express a different opinion? How dare you do this? So if you want to be that society, then let's decide now. India can be very good slaves to the world. We have been for 1,000 years. We were slaves. And I think that's where the mindset comes. But if you want great art, it will be offensive sometimes. It will piss you off. You can criticize it. You can say this is nonsense. You can say this is garbage. You can say this is perverse, perverted, whatever. But if you say ban it, you know,
you're saying basically, rather than ban a book, don't read it. You don't want to read a book, that's fine. But don't ban books, don't ban plays, don't ban movies. Don't go and attack a theater simply because you have a problem with the theme of
it. You can shame it. Forget, don't read it. You can even shame it. You can say, this is a horrible movie. This is the worst movie ever made. This guy is a liar. This guy is a... That's okay. That's still a debate. But the moment you start saying, ban it, jail him.
So what happened when...
It has happened to comedians. It has happened to all kinds of artists of all kinds. And I think... I mean, I've been lucky and I don't go into those zones maybe that it offends people that much. But even if someone is offending, I am telling you, they are offensive. I found offensive artists in my country. But let them be there, because their freedom of expression is your freedom of expression. If you today cut someone's freedom of expression because it upset you, tomorrow your freedom of expression will be taken away and you will not have a democracy anymore. So
let me therefore turn to one of your themes, which may have again pushed the boundary. Two states. The story of my marriage, where you know, it was a classical ek duje ke liye, but for the 21st century. Boy from one part of India, north meets south. The girl from southern India, boy from north India. Was that again autobiographical strongly? And do you again believe that is something which again people, you know, resonates with campus? I don't know how many of you have relationships of girlfriend or boyfriend is from a different state. How many from a different state put up their hands? How many of you have a girlfriend or boyfriend from a different state? See, now fewer of you are putting up your hands.
But sir, because the relationship, maine bhi realize kiya, two relationship wale kam hai, half girlfriend wale jyada hai. To uske baad jo next book aayi, wo half girlfriend thi. But two states, you're right. In fact, I remember when I was about to write it, I also referenced Ek Dooje Ke Liye. In fact, that's referenced in the book also. And my wife also said, what are you writing? This is a 1980s movie, but this will not work. I said, but this is what I want to write. And my difference was, in Ek Dooje Ke Liye, The girl's side says, no, you are not going to marry your daughter. And they beat the hell out of Kamal Hassan, right? They beat the shit out of him. But I said, what if the girl's father folds his hands and says, please, we can't marry your daughter to you. Can you please leave us alone? Then what do you do? When they are not beating, because if it's a hero-villain situation, you can make a story. Now how do you win them over? When they say, sorry, we can't do this. We are simple people. Please leave us and our daughter alone. How do you win them over? I thought that will be a more interesting and more realistic story. Because I think most...
And that's your story.
Sort of.
Is that your story? I mean, it is your story.
Yes, it's spiced up. It's very spiced up. Okay, my mother is not like that in the movie. It's a bit exaggerated. Amrita also took it to a different level of mother-in-law. And yeah, even my in-laws are not so bad to me like they are in the movie. But
Because then you came up with half girlfriend.
Yes.
Which I'm
everybody
sure
has. How many of you have half girlfriends?
Half girlfriend, the boy is from rural Bihar and the girl was a sophisticated girl from Delhi. How many of you have half girlfriends? Sach batao, raise your hands.
Man mein girlfriend. Instagram pe hai. Abhi kar rahe hain dekho sachche log.
How many of you have Instagram girlfriends? You see, half girlfriend Chetan was written before the Instagram generation came.
Yes, yes.
So in a way, you know, you write a book in 2014. 10 years later, people are dating, even getting married based on Instagram relationships. You know, the world seems to be changing even faster than a fiction writer could imagine.
Yes. No, so I have. In fact, my latest book, 400 Days, is about a child's kidnapping who, when they have to figure out who kidnapped her, they use Instagram to figure out. They see the girl's Instagram account. So it has changed. And yeah, the boys today, they think they have an Instagram girlfriend, but many of them don't. Ek to main aaj itne saare ladke yahan baithe, main unhe ek cheez bolunga. Ye ladkiyon ki photo pe like karna band karo. Ye jo tum karte rehte ho na, सारा दिन बैठ के थोड़ी पढ़ाई कर लो, कुछ करियर बना लो. एक कोई ऐसे अदिति ने फोटो लगा दी और तुमने ऐसे लाइक दबा दबा के इमोजी डाले जा रहे हो, एंजल फ्रॉम हेवन. क्या कर रहे हो यार? क्योंकि मैं देखता हूँ, आई सी दीज गर्ल्स एंड आई मीन लाइक हम यहाँ राजदीप इतने लंबे लंबे प्रोग्राम बना रहे हैं, 50 लाइक्स. मैं बना रहा हूँ 200 लाइक. उसने एक फोटो लगा दी अपनी छुट्टी की गोवा की, बाप रे 200,000 लाइक आ रहे हैं. है एंजल फ्रॉम. और तुम्हें क्या लगता है कि तुम ऐसे लिखोगे और फायर का इमोजी लगा दोगे तो वो बोलेगी आदिति, यार ये मनोज रोज मुझे फायर इमोजी भेजता
है.
नहीं, अभी चलती हूं उसके साथ डेट पे. कोई लड़की गई है आज तक ऐसे? दिस इज सिंपिंग एंड स्टॉप इट. जस्ट स्टॉप गिविंग लाइक ओनली योर गर्लफ्रेंड. यू लाइक एवरी पोस्ट ऑफ हर्स. यस, अगर तुम्हारी गर्लफ्रेंड है तो उसकी पोस्ट 4 अकाउंट बना के लाइक करो, वो अलग बात है. पर ऐसे रैंडम आदिति आरती ये सब ऐसे करे जा रहे, तुम्हें क्या मिल रहा है इसका? हाँ, बंद करो ये.
अच्छा, यू आर आस्किंग देम टू डिस्कवर रियल लव. इंस्टा लव में मत जाइए, रियल लव डिस्कवर करिए. यू सी दैट इवन विद अ बुक टुडे वी आर इन दिस एज ऑफ सोशल मीडिया वेयर यू इन यू नो वेदर इट इज ट्विटर, फेसबुक, इंस्टाग्राम, इवन स्नैपचैट, एवरीथिंग इज बाइट साइज. नाउ योर बुक साइज इज 200 पेजेस, सो यू एक्सपेक्ट समवन टू स्पेंड एटलीस्ट अ डे, यू नो, कपल ऑफ डेज गोइंग थ्रू अ बुक. Do you believe that social media has therefore made even books sooner or later bite-sized? I see, you know, shorter books being written than ever before. Do you have to adjust in a way to this social media age?
To a certain extent, yes. My more recent books are shorter. They are even simpler to read. I switched to murder mysteries for a while because that is more attention grabbing and we are in the war for attention. So yes, you're right about that. At the same time, you know, books have their charm, which Instagram reels won't. I try to write simple books that anybody can read, but Rajdeep, I must have one grudge against the publishing industry or literary crowd who, koi book uthata hai na, usse judge karne baith jate hain. Arre, tu Chetan Bhagat padhta hai? Tu Salman Rushdie nahi padh raha? You know, like they are creating a class system. Aur reels dekhte raho sara din baith ke, koi nahi. Usme koi nahi kehta kuch. Someone has finally picked up a book and we start judging it. कि यार ये तो ये पढ़ रहा है, इससे हाई लिटरेचर पढ़ा करो. अरे वो क्या करता है, वो किताब बंद करता है. ही डजंट गो टू द हाई लिटरेचर, ही और शी गोज बैक टू द रील्स. सो गाइस, रीडिंग इज इम्पोर्टेंट.
आप रील्स किया करो.
नहीं, हाँ, वी डू रील्स. आई डू रील्स, आई हैव अ यूट्यूब चैनल, आई डू एवरीथिंग. बट गाइस, एंड आई डू एवरीथिंग, बट रीडिंग इज रीडिंग. इट्स लाइक सेइंग देयर आर सम पीपल हु वेरी प्राउडली से हम तो सिर्फ वीडियो देखते हैं, हम बुक्स नहीं पढ़ते. यू नो व्हाट इट्स लाइक सेइंग, गाड़ी है तो पांव क्यों चलाने हैं, पैदल नहीं चलता मैं तो गाड़ी में ही बैठता हूं. आर यू गाइस स्टूपिड? राइट, यू हैव टू यूज योर ब्रेन, यू हैव टू यूज योर माइंड, एंड द रीडिंग इज गोइंग टू शो. जो बंदा बुक्स पढ़ता है उसे वेल रेड पर्सन बोलते हैं. किसी को बोला तक वेल टीवी वॉच्ड पर्सन, वेल रील वॉच्ड पर्सन? तुम्हारे दिमाग का दही हो रहा है, वो तुम्हारा भरता बना रहे हैं. मार्क जकरबर्ग भैया करोड़ों कमा रहे हैं, तुम्हें नूडल्स बेच बेच के इंस्टाग्राम पे, टी शर्ट्स बेच बेच के, और तुम्हें लग रहा है तुम ओह आई एम सो कूल मैन, आई डोंट रीड बुक्स एंड ऑल, आई वॉच रील्स. ड्यूड, यू आर द प्रोडक्ट, यू आर गेटिंग यूज्ड. रीडिंग इज कमिंग बैक. आई थॉट इट्स गोना गो अवे, बट इट्स कमिंग बैक. जस्ट एज लाइव इवेंट्स आर कमिंग बैक, पीपल आर कमिंग टू दिस. लुक एट ऑल द कॉन्सर्ट्स दैट आर अनाउंस्ड इमीडिएटली, टिकट्स ऑफ 10,000 गेट सोल्ड. पीपल आर डिस्कवरिंग कि ये जो वीडियो की दुनिया है, दिस इज फेक एंड इट डज नथिंग फॉर योर ब्रेन. It doesn't relax you. You think you're sitting watching reel? No. Read a book. You'll get immersed in the story. Not mine. Koi bhi padh lo.
But you see, you know, the fact is that, let's say on Twitter, where you have a large following, someone says, hey, Chetan Bhagat bakwas writer hai. Mujhe padhna nahi hai. Chetan Bhagat ki English mujhe padhni nahi hai. Do you get upset? Do you get angry? Does it trouble you? Or do you believe part of life, and you had a book also on how do you deal with the struggles of life?
तो रोज बोलते हैं, एंड आई थिंक अगर आप इफ यू आस्क मी दिस क्वेश्चन 15 इयर्स बैक, आई वुड हैव बिकम वेरी डिफेंसिव एंड कहता हाँ ऐसे क्यों, एवरीबॉडी लाइक मैं, मेरी इंग्लिश अच्छी है यो ऐसे. बट अब मेरी ना राजदीप एक थ्योरी है, मैं आपको भी बता देता हूँ, शायद आपके काम आएगी. आई हैव दिस पपीता थ्योरी इन लाइफ.
पपीता?
हाँ, पपाया. यू लाइक पपाया?
आई लव पपाया.
बट यू नो इट्स वन ऑफ दोज फ्रूट्स, सम पीपल लाइक बनाना एवरीबडी लाइक्स, मैंगो एवरीबडी लाइक्स, बट पपाया ऐसा चीज है कईयों को अच्छा लगता है कईयों को नहीं लगता है. इट्स वन ऑफ दोज फ्रूट्स,
अक्वायर्ड टेस्ट.
हाँ, इसमें पपीते की गलती है, पपीते की तो गलती नहीं है ना. अब पपीते को क्या कहते हैं, आई हेट पपीता, पपीता क्या करे, आई लव पपीता, पपीता क्या करे. पपीता कोई केला थोड़ा बन जाएगा, वो केला बनने की कोशिश करेगा और खराब हो जाएगा. सो आई एम द पपीता. यू लाइक इट, ग्रेट, डोंट लाइक इट, ओके, कुछ और खा लो.
आपने हमें यू गिवन अस अ इंस्टाग्राम वन लाइनर, चेतन भगत पपीता है.
पपीता, हम सबको पपीता थ्योरी अप्लाई करनी चाहिए लाइफ में यार, कि यू नो एवरीबॉडी विल नॉट लाइक यू, इट्स ओके. सबको क्यों पसंद करना है तुम्हें?
यू आर ओके विद दैट?
आई थिंक वी ऑल हैव टू बी ओके विद दैट, नहीं तो सारे के सारे केले बन के रह जाओगे. केले, सारी दुनिया में केले ही केले होंगे तो क्या फायदा होगा?
यू नो बिकॉज यू रोट a book which became a very fine movie, I enjoyed it greatly, The Three Mistakes of My Life.
Kai Poche, yes.
Kai Poche, which was set against the backdrop of the Gujarat riots. And it was, how many of you have seen Kai Poche?
Yeah, Sushant's first movie.
You know, it was Sushant Singh Rajput's first movie, and it was a very, very good, well-made movie. It was a book which resonated with me since I had covered the Gujarat riots. So there you were actually pushing the boundaries in a way by talking about a contemporary event which divided people. Do you believe that's okay? Do you believe you were entering unfamiliar territory? Was that a kind of book which excited you when you were writing it?
Yeah, I mean, I was very... us time pe maine socha bhi nahi ki it could become such a big issue. But nowadays when I see what happens to certain movies, I think it's a miracle that that book came out and went, and the movie came out, and I must give credit for something, you know. At that time, it was CM Modi, not PM Modi. And we had gone to Gujarat, and we said, we want to make this movie. This is the story of this movie. It's like this. And we want to shoot it in Gujarat only, because it's set in Gujarat. And he fully supported, and that is the fact. And we, in fact, shot all the scenes of Kai Poche, where the temple and all are there, are shot in Vadnagar, which is his own kind of constituency. So maybe at that time we got all the support for it, and I think the movie or the story tries to be balanced. In that case, I think we did try to do that job. But imagine if such movies are never made. All the movies that are made are like, you know, just fantasy kind of movies, or aise purani koi legend ko leke bana diya. If we never make movies about education, if we never make movies about, you know, intercaste marriage or intercultural marriage, if we never make, isn't that something missing in society? Sirf circus dekhne jaate ho kya cinema? You know?
So you're saying whether movies or books, should tackle these contemporary themes, social commentary more and more.
If you ask me, I'll feel that is the only reason to write them. But okay, you can write them for pure entertainment also, I don't judge. But I think that's what gives art purpose. Otherwise, to kahaniya. You can all watch reels and do your time pass. Agar time pass hi karna to, but I think every story is an opportunity to make people think a little bit. Mm-hmm. And give a broader narrative. And sometimes it make you feel uncomfortable. Let's say there is a movie on, I don't know.
Would you write on Hindu, you know, there is this whole talk of love jihad. Since we are talking of love and romance. If a Muslim boy marries a Hindu girl, koi kehta love jihad ho gaya. I've never been able to understand. What if if they are in love with each other? They're perfectly entitled everyone has the right to marry whoever they want, right or wrong. Do you agree? Each of you have a right to marry whoever you want, right?
As long as the other person agrees.
If it's a love marriage, what's the harm? So the point is, would you explore a theme like that in the future?
I could, but I mean, there are a couple of factors. One is, if that, and you have to be honest with yourself, if that is the theme that is bothering you, not letting you sleep at night, you know, if you have some experience of that, like someone in the family had that situation or me, am I able to bring an angle to it, which is like somewhat unique? But yes, why not? I mean, but at mera kabhi hua nahi love jihad type itna aisa situation. I don't have to personally experience it. Like I said, I wrote a book on call centers at one time, one night at a call center, which was the whole, at that time call centers were being celebrated. Ki isse badhiya koi cheez nahi aayi. But the people inside had a lot of issues. So I wrote a book on that based on talking to call center people. So it depends on what. If it fascinates me, I could do it. But yes, what you are saying would possibly be a talk. But will we let such a movie release? Would we let such a movie say, they may say love jihad is okay. They may say love jihad is wrong. They may, I don't know. It depends on the creator, na? Uski marzi hai. So,
people had even objected, if you recall, a few years ago to an advertisement where the girl was dressed the boy was dressed in Muslim clothes, the girl in Hindu clothes. I think it was a watch ad, and there was a lot of there was a question mark over the way people had been portrayed. You're saying Jio or Jine Do. That's your motto in life. When you write a book or anything in life, Jio or Jine Do.
Yeah, especially a country like India where we have so many different points of view, so many different cultures, and frankly, ab itne jobless ho kyun? कि आप प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हो बैठ के किसी मूवी, तुम्हारी इसका मतलब है तुम्हारी लाइफ में कोई पर्पस नहीं है, तुम वेले हो और वेलों का काम है ये करना. यू नो पीपल जस्ट, इफ यू आर रियली प्रोडक्टिवली, इफ यू हैव अ ग्रेट जॉब एंड यू हैव एन अमेजिंग गर्लफ्रेंड और बॉयफ्रेंड, यू नॉट गोना हैव टाइम टू से कि ये कैसी एड बनाई है, ये गलत है, आज पूरा दिन हम ट्विटर पे लड़ेंगे इसके लिए. ओनली जॉबलेस वेले लोग करते हैं ये काम. तो इफ यू आर डूइंग, यू कैच योरसेल्फ डूइंग दिस, I think it's a bigger message is कि अपनी लाइफ में कुछ बनो और लोगों को भी जीने दो, लाइक यू सेड, एंड अपनी भी लाइफ को कुछ बनाओ यार. दिस कंट्री विल सॉर्ट इट सेल्फ आउट. पीपल डोंट गेट, नो रिलीजन गेट्स डैमेज और नो कंट्री गेट्स डैमेज बाय वन लिटिल पीस ऑफ आर्ट दैट विल बी फॉरगॉटन इन 10 डेज एनी वे.
ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ रैपिड फायर राउंड विद चेतन भगत.
अरे बाप रे,
आई एम गोइंग टू ट्राई एंड
यहां फंसता आदमी.
नहीं, वो करण जौहर टाइप करेंगे अपन.
Hate, love, carry, marry. No, hook up, love, marry.
Okay, my first question. Which politician do you admire the most? Narendra Modi, Rahul Gandhi or Arvind Kejriwal?
Tino scud hai. Honest baat hai. If you are talking about admiration, all three are super stud. Very good politicians, all three of them.
Arre nahi, ye.
Maine ye bola to main bhi acha politician ban gaya. नहीं नहीं यार, ये
अच्छा, okay.
ऐसे कैसे बोलो, बिकॉज ऑल थ्री ब्रिंग समथिंग टू द टेबल. ऑल थ्री आर इंडियंस, यू नो दैट, राइट? दोनों, तीनों हैं एंड तीनों अपने बात को
लाइक द आंसर. इफ यू डिडंट लाइक इट, थम्स डाउन. देखो, लोगों को डिप्लोमेसी अच्छी नहीं लगती.
मैंने कहा ना मैं पपीता हूँ.
अच्छा, ये बताओ, योर हु डू यू थिंक इज द एक्टर यू एडमायर मोस्ट? अमिताभ बच्चन, शाहरुख खान, रजनीकांत और कमल हसन?
आई थिंक आई एम लिटिल बायस्ड बिकॉज आई हैव इंटरैक्टेड विद शाहरुख आउट ऑफ दीज द मोस्ट, दे आर ऑल गुड एक्टर्स. बट शाहरुख एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग, लाइक आई विल टेल यू वन थिंग, आई विल गिव एन एग्जांपल, टू एग्जांपल्स एक्चुअली. आई हैव I've not done a movie with him, but I've gone to his house once. We went for some work only. And I've gone to the houses of actors who've done my movies, and many actors people. Shah Rukh is the only one who walked out of his house to see me to my car. So that's the kind of manners he has. Once I remember Om Shanti Om was being shot, and at that time I was new, I was not that popular also. One book had come, and my mother was there, and she wanted to see the shooting. So I took her, and you know, she was standing there. The shot got over, and he saw that my mother is older. He went, and nobody on the set thought of it, and he picked up a chair and got a chair for my mother. So I think that level of person, how can I like...
Okay, so we've given it to Shah Rukh Khan. Yes. That's a clear answer. Thumbs up for that answer. At least you've been very clear on that.
Politicians,
if you had 24 hours to go to an Indian city that you love the most, would you choose Delhi? Would you choose Kolkata? Would you choose Mumbai? Or would you choose Bengaluru? Where would you come if you wanted to have a good time? Saturday night, which is the city that you think is the best place to go for a Saturday night?
That's a very good question actually. So, 24 mein se Bangalore mein 6 ghante to traffic mein hi laga lo. Theek hai? So, aur 8 ghante you know, just for me, I would pick Delhi. I'm from there. I have friends there. Delhi can be fun. I'm a little Punjabi, so mujhe wo Punjabi type gaane, Punjabi type khana mere liye fun hai. But maybe for others, I've heard Bangalore is fun. There are some nice places here. But ek din traffic paar karke pahunch hi jayenge.
Cricket, Bollywood or politics? What is Chetan Bhagat's first love?
I love, in terms of just watching and observing, I think I'm a bit like you. I can't tell about you because for you cricket is, I think, very big. For me, it's politics. You know, I don't like watching too much sport. I feel you are watching other men achieve excellence. You should spend the time achieving excellence yourself. Watch 10 minutes, get inspired by those Olympic players, cricket players, and then go do it yourself. Ye jo fan pandi karte rehte na sara din, you are like wasting your own life. I don't like to watch. It's my view. Papita hun, that's up to you.
If you have to...
I love politics because it is the ultimate brain involvement. Like, doing politics is so difficult. Trying to convince people to go along with you and not go along with someone else, it's fascinating for me. That's like, for a writer, it naturally fits understanding society. So for me, if you like election results versus World Cup final, okay, what about you? Election results versus World Cup final? Final Lok Sabha election result, World Cup final?
No, for me, live election day live is the best thing on TV.
Yeah.
Because so, I love to see politicians who think they are winning actually losing. I love to see their face.
It's real stakes.
Yeah, so, but you know, cricket is in my blood, so it's also part of my life. I would watch a cricket match, but I would love to be involved in covering a live election. There's nothing to beat that. But you're the one who has to answer the question. Two final questions. Breakfast. If you had a choice between Sunday morning breakfast tomorrow morning, idli dosa at MTR, paratha at Chandni Chowk, or poha at Dadar Shivaji Park. What is Chetan Bhagat's choice for a good Sunday morning breakfast?
Rajdeep, mera abhi ek trainer hai aur ye tino rejected breakfast hai. Kyunki tino carbs, carbs aur carbs. To protein khana hai. To ande khane padenge. Koi choice nahi hai. Ya mat khao breakfast.
Acha, tum ande ke aadmi ho.
Ande, yaar, it's really bad now. I have to eat so much protein. And
Given ande. Okay, I'm going to give the audience a couple of questions. Who in the audience? Is there a mic there?
If you want to ask a question, that's what he's saying.
Anyone in the audience? Yes, that boy there has been keeping his hand up for a while. Please give him the mic there. Come forward. Please come.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Tell us your name first.
Hello, Chetan Bhagat, sir. Rajdeep, sir.
Kya naam hai aapka? What's your name?
My name is Shatadru Mukherjee.
Okay.
I'm from Kolkata. So, sir, it's a request from my side to Chetan Bhagat, sir. Actually, I read these three mistakes of my life after it was released some 1 or 2 years later. And as at that time, I was not very much into politics. I didn't keep note of what's happening in politics. I was unaware about Gujarat incident. So I got to know everything about Gujarat incident after I read the book. So my request to you is, sir, now there is a very bad incident that's going on in Bengal. We all know about it, but maybe some youth who is staying far off from Kolkata doesn't know what's going on in about Arjikar and the kind of politics that is happening and this East Bengal.
So you want of, you want him to write a book on Arjikar and what is happening?
Yes, yes, definitely.
Okay.
मुझे खुद ही नहीं पता है exactly किसको पता है exactly क्या हो रहा है वहाँ पे अभी.
So but either way, if
Rajiv sir will be able to help,
I'll be able to tell you if is that the kind you would you like to write more and more on contemporary politics?
I would love to, but like I said, you need to be honest with yourself that see there is a lot of problems in the country. There are some that we feel very strongly about. Like there may be someone in the audience who feels very strongly about animal rights, right? And someone else may feel strongly about something else. So it has to resonate with me for it to be an effective book. But definitely it is, you know, something like this is, I don't know if I can do a book on a specific individual case. That's not my thing.
Okay.
But yeah.
Okay, the girl here is wanting
yes,
to ask
there
a question.
Also.
Go ahead, ma'am.
Yes, sir. I am actually a very big fan of you.
What's your name?
My name is Manya Singh. I started reading books because of you.
Thank you.
And your book, One Indian Girl, made me like, mujhe itna interest aaya that I am pursuing investment banking right now because
wow.
of you.
Oh, thank you.
Arre, par ye toh investment banker hote hote author ban gaye.
Haan.
But still, I would like to ask that what values did you got from IIM Ahmedabad which you carry right now?
I'll tell you, so you know the course and all is good, but what that place did I think for me is a very underrated but rare quality is it teaches you how to think. And I know everybody thinks, but we don't really think. You know, we are often reacting to things. We are often, our thoughts are not our own. They are based on what other people have said to us. We've read somewhere, seen somewhere. And I would say the moment you learn how to think, which means how to solve a problem, you can solve anything in life, even your career or your health or anything else. The step-by-step way of thinking.
So what's your one tip to this young audience for success in life? Everyone wants to achieve in his or her field success. As someone who went through a very unusual career journey, IIT, IIM, went to investment banking, became a best-selling author, what's your one tip of success to the young?
It's a lot of tips. I have a book called 11 Rules for Life. You can read it if you want to know fully. But I would say live a life of purpose and discipline, you know. Discipline trumps motivation. Discipline trumps everything. Just hard discipline. I know it sounds fun. I wrote 2 states. Oh, 3 idiots. It sounds like a fun thing. It's a grind to write. You've written a book this year, right? Isn't it one of the hardest things to do?
I've been getting up for the last 100 days every morning at 5 in the morning. Because the only way you can write a book is between 5 and 9 in the morning when nobody disturbs you.
Yeah, so...
So are you willing to wake up every day for 100 days at 5 in the morning?
So it's the hardest thing for me. Like IIT exam was nothing. And even though I'm writing a comedy, I'm writing a love story. The discipline a book requires... And even now that you've already done it, you know, abhi kitna kar liya aur kare. So I think just that.
Okay.
I'm not a genius. I'm not a huge writing talent. I have some talent, yes. But where I have won is because I've been at it for 20 years.
And lage that, raho.
Lage raho bas.
Basically, apna time aayega, lage raho. That's the message. If you can continue to focus on doing what you do or what you like to do and are disciplined, you can become the next Chetan Bhagat. So Chetan, thank you very much for joining us. You are looking extremely fit and trim.
Thank you, Rajdeep. You have also lost a lot of weight and I heard like it's because of your son's clinic.
My son is a facial aesthetic surgeon, so he makes me go on a particular diet. But you've been remarkably fit as well. I am older
that also
than...
discipline, Rajdeep. It's all discipline.
Chaliye, discipline. The one first word at Mind Rocks, if you want your mind to rock, remember, stay disciplined. The one and only Chetan Bhagat, ladies and gentlemen, give him a very big hand.
Thank you.